This is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and in this video I'll be going over the use of constants and also talking about coding standards. So the style in your code is very important to make sure that you can read it and remember what you've done when you go back and look at it later, and also if other people need to look at your code and modify it. So a number of components here. We've already talked a little bit about commenting, so remember you can do single line comments with the slash slash, or you can do comments that go across multiple lines with the slash star notation. Indentation is also important. So you're going to want to indent code that's in between any sets of curly braces. And that really helps set off and mark that code as being part of something. We'll talk more about that later. It's also really good to put spacing in your code to space out different sections of your code. And we have talked about using variable meaning names, meaningful variable names. So you definitely want to follow camel case naming convention, where you're squishing the words together but capitalizing the beginning of each subsequent word after the first, which you don't capitalize. Another way to think about meaningful variable names is to consider whether or not your variable names are self-commenting. So in this example, we have int t slash slash tax rate. So we had to add a comment to explain what that t meant. That's not very good because later on in the code, you'll see the t and you have to then remember what it means. If instead you use the variable name tax rate, that's self-explanatory and you don't need to put a comment in. And that's helpful later on when you see that variable in your code. And the last thing is to use named constants, which we're going to talk about and explain in this video. But let's just look at some example. So this is an example processing script, and it does not follow good coding style. Everything is squished together. There's no good spacing. There's no indentation. We have all of these variable names that are really not good and meaningful. So here we have this line that says y plus equals dy times e. I look at that and I'm like, I have no idea what that's trying to do. Okay? This is the exact same program, but in good style. So it's got a good big explanatory comment at the top that explains what the program is trying to do. The variable names are actually, you know, meaningful. So circle X, circle Y, the locations of the X and Y, and easing. So that's, you know, some parameter. And then there's spacing between different things, between the setup and the draw, okay? And here you can see, if I look down, now I have circ Y plus equals the delta Y times the easing. So now I have a much better idea of what that line is doing versus this one over here, okay? All right, so what we want to aim for is readable code. And, you know, it's this example should help you understand why that's important. So here we've got three lines of code and we look at them and we see we've got these variables and we've just got these numbers. Well, what do these numbers mean? What do they represent? They could be like almost anything. So maybe they're a business cost calculation. So maybe the first number is the cost of a service. The second number, 5, is maybe the number of days per week that the business is open. And the third number, 26, maybe that's the number of weeks per year the business is open. Could be, we don't know. Let's assume it is. How could we name this better? We want to think about what we could do there. So problems with the above example. So one problem is that it's just hard to understand what it means. But the other problem is, what if you decided that you're going to be open 30 weeks per year? Then you've got to change this in 3 spots, okay? And so you might change it in 2 spots, forget to change it in the third, and then your program does some weird things and you have weird costs that don't make sense, okay? So hard to read and hard to change or update. All right, so what we can do is we can create constants. So constants are like variables, but we add the keyword final before we declare them. And then it becomes not variable. So when you create a constant, you're creating a box in memory, you're putting something in it, but you can't change what's in that box. You can put one thing in that box and never change it to anything else. Okay? So the convention when we're writing programs and we use constants is to use all uppercase letters. It looks like you're being shouted at. So a constant is like, don't change me, I'm important. All right, so instead of the camel case, which we use for variables. All right, so here's an example. Here's a variable, int current size equals 20. And we know that this sort of looks like this. We've got a box in memory, we have a type, we have a name, and we have a value, right? So constants look very similar, but we have this final keyword, right? And they get declared in sort of similar ways. So you can declare it and then put something in it, or you can do it all in one line, right? So here we're creating it up here, final int days per week, and then on the next line, we actually put a value in, or you could do it all on one line like this. Regardless, the point here is that once 5 is in this box, we cannot, while the program is running, have this change, okay? So the constant might be used 100 times in the program, and if we decide that actually the days per week that the business is open is 4, the programmer can change this once while they're programming at the beginning where it's declared, but it can't change in the middle of the program while the program is running. So let's go back to this example and look at how we would improve this. So by using constants for days per week and for weeks per year, then this starts to look like something that's more meaningful. We can make it even better when we actually use variables to say what these things are. So maybe this is something like hydro cost equals the hydro daily cost times the days per week times the weeks per year. Same for water cost and for cable cost. So now this code is actually very meaningful because we've got well-named variables and constants that are meaningful. All right, so you want to use constants whenever you have anything in your program that requires sort of a specific number that's going to stay the same. You don't want to just have numbers in your program because they just don't mean things to people. So you want this to help be readable, and you want to use it whenever you're not going to change something. So for example, here we've got position x times 6. That's bad. It's a magic number. Like, what is 6? Why 6? What does that stand for? What is that doing? But if you create a constant that's called your x scale factor and you set it to 6, now we say, oh, we're taking the position and we're scaling it. Oh, that's what we're doing. So that's much more meaningful. All right. So this increases the readability of your code, but it also increases the reliability because as long as you use the constants throughout, if you decide you need to change what that constant value is, you only have to change it in one place. So let's look at a drawing example in processing. So here we have this program that I wrote. It's called Lines, Triangles, Ovals. It's an artsy program, and it basically draws a bunch of stuff. So let's run it, and so we see we've got these weird putrid color ovals and these purple lines and these turquoise triangles all coming from this sort of one spot on screen. If we look at the code, you see we're drawing thick lines and we've got setting a stroke color, drawing a line, setting a stroke color, drawing a triangle, setting a stroke color, drawing an ellipse, and then we're doing it again with a different line thickness. And these things where we're drawing the lines and the triangles and the rectangles, they're all being drawn from this same location, 75, 100, right? That's the location for starting or centering the ellipse or starting the triangle or the line. And you see that that's throughout the program. So if we suddenly decided that we wanted all of this sort of burst center to be down here, you can see that we're gonna have to change the 75 and 100 all through this program. And that's just not a good idea. We're likely to miss one or type in the wrong number somewhere, and then it won't work the way we expect. Similarly, we've got these colors. So this is the line color, which is that purple, and we've got it again here, and we've got it again here before every line. So it would make more sense if we could create some constants. So let's close this. And then let's look at a different example of this. So this is the exact same program, version 2, where I've got 5 constants. So I've got 3 color constants for the line color, the triangle color, and the oval color. And I've got 2 int constants, x and y, burst x and burst y, for the location of where those shapes should be drawn from. And then they're used throughout this program. So this program is still as long. It's actually got a few more lines of code because of these constants, and it does the same thing. So we run it and it looks the same. Every time we run this, because of some randoms in here, is gonna look slightly different, but it's doing the same type of thing. A bunch of ovals centered here, a bunch of lines coming up from here, and a bunch of turquoise triangles. Okay, now, so in this case, if I want to change something, if I want to change this location, so that maybe it's actually everything is coming out from the center of the screen, here I only have to do this in one place. So I could do burst x equals width divided by 2. So that's the width of the canvas, and height divided by 2, okay? And if I stop the current one and rerun it, there we go. And so I didn't have to go through the whole program and change it everywhere because I've got this constant that's used everywhere. I only had to change it in this one place. So I had to make 2 changes to change x and y instead of having to change them in every drawing function down here, all right? We could also say I don't like this color, this oval. It's like kind of weird and putrid looking. I could come in and change that here and try a different color. Okay, so that's kind of different. It's kind of a weird green color. And again, I only had to change it in this one place. I didn't have to change it every time I'm specifying the color for the oval. So you can see that using these constants helps make sure that your code is easier to change and update without making a lot of mistakes. All right, so last thing is just to reiterate this canvas width and height thing, which is just a weird processing thing and kind of doesn't really follow the rules, okay? So the size, width, and height command has to use numbers. You can't put variables in here. So typically we've done this size 500, 500, all right? And it seems like in this case, it would be better to do something like final int canvas size equals 500 and do that and do size, canvas size, canvas size. But this is actually not allowed. The canvas size, the size command has to be one of the first things in your program and it has to actually have literals in it. Okay. So the nice thing though, just to remind you, is that once you've called size, you do have these sort of built-in constants width and height that you can use. So for example, here we can say size 400, 600, and now we have these and we can use them. Ellipse width divided by 2, height divided by 2, width and height, and that will help us draw the biggest ellipse possible on the canvas, which looks like this. And again, in terms of not following the rules, what seems funny is that, you know, this width and height, really, these are sort of constants that processing makes for you once you call the size function, but processing, for whatever reason, doesn't do all caps on them. They're small letters, like a variable name. Anyhow, processing has its quirks. All right, so just a reminder, standards that you need to follow whenever you're coding and doing your assignments. Use good variable names that make sense and are meaningful. Use the camel case to create them. And then use constants that have all caps and underscores in the names. Use good indentation and spacing to help make your code more reasonable. And put lots of comments in. And actually, you should really err on the side of too many comments rather than having too few. All right, and there'll be more standards that will come as we develop more skills in programming. Thanks for watching.